When OnePlus told me the new 13 was coming out, I asked him if I could throw it off the roof of a 20-foot-tall building, and surprisingly, they said yes.
See ya.
One thing you might not have noticed, though, while watching this flagship phone succumb to gravity, is that we actually threw the OnePlus 13 off the roof twice. Once to get the shot of tossing it and it landing on the ground, and a second time just for fun, obviously, but also to throw a camera alongside the phone at the same time to get the epic shot of it falling through the air like Mary Jane in that one Spider-Man movie. Obviously, this isn't normal behavior and you shouldn't try this at home, but it is cool to see that the phone survived a 20-foot drop twice. I also slathered it in motor oil and stuck it in a steamy dishwasher for 30 minutes because extreme durability testing is kind of my thing. And here we are, back at my desk with the phone very much alive, in one piece, and surprisingly still in near-perfect condition. I told OnePlus that for good measure, I'll need to check the water damage indicator stickers inside just to see if any of the hot jets of steam from the dishwasher got inside the phone, since not all water damage occurs instantly. And again, OnePlus agreed. It says a lot when a brand wants to show off their phone in such an in-depth way. So thanks to OnePlus for the early access and sponsoring this world's first look inside the OnePlus 13. I'm taking apart the Midnight Ocean microfiber OnePlus 13, which is my personal favorite of the three, since the flexible panel is much less likely to shatter than glass would. But there's also the White Arctic Dawn, with a frosted textured glass, kinda reminds me of Olaf on a sunny day. The third color, the Black Eclipse, has a very unique rosewood grain wood texture etched into the back glass panel, which is fascinating. Rosewood is one of the more sought-after materials in luxury furniture making, so it's super cool to see the same texture imitated with glass, and I'm a fan of the creativity. With the microfiber panel removed from the Midnight Ocean OnePlus 13, we can immediately see that neither of the two water damage indicators are tripped. See, the two little white circular stickers have red dye on the backside, so if any liquid gets into the phone, the ink will slowly bleed into the top layer, tattling on you for any water damage that might have occurred. But even after the two 20-foot drops, engine oil, and 30 minutes in a steamy dishwasher, the OnePlus 13 is still solidly sealed tight. Thumbs up for that. The bottom of the phone has 8 normal Phillips head screws holding down the loudspeaker. The top plastics have 12 screws of their own, which have red thread locker keeping them in place. Nice little throwback to the red battery days. The top plastics here are a little more important than usual, since OnePlus is introducing a new walkie-talkie feature called Beacon Link that helps keep you connected with just a Bluetooth signal from up to 200 meters away. Excellent feature for backpacking outside of regular service areas or journeying through the foothills of Gondor. Beacons are always a good thing to have. The 50-watt wireless charger is attached to these plastics as well. The tightly coiled copper wires allow the OnePlus 13 to charge faster wirelessly than most other phones can charge while actually plugged in. Pretty impressive. I'll unplug the battery like a little Lego before popping off the lower loudspeaker. Pulling up the black sticker, we do see it has some balls inside. The balls help the speaker sound bigger than it actually is, which is a good thing. The battery comes out next, and while it's not red anymore, OnePlus has again graced us with some pretty solid pull tabs, making battery removal fairly simple. This is a 6,000 mAh dual-cell silicon nanostack battery that's capable of charging at 100 watts with the very specific, specially designed OnePlus SuperVoog 100-watt dual-port power adapter. It can go from 1 to 100% capacity in just 36 minutes. The anode is a 10% silicon carbon composite, which is what's allowed OnePlus to cram more juice into a thinner device and smaller space than last time. The battery sits on top of the largest vapor chamber we've ever seen outside of a laptop. There are technically two vapor chambers, which OnePlus is calling a cryovelocity cooling system. I assume the battery placement over the chambers helps keep the charging temperature optimized, but we'll have to check that out in a second. The motherboard has two silver Phillips head screws of its own, and it's very interesting that after it's removed from the frame, there's two locations where the dual cryovelocity vapor chamber has direct contact with the motherboard. It looks like the 50 megapixel telephoto camera also rests right on top of the copper, just like the processor. Each of the cameras inside the OnePlus 13 are 50 megapixels. The larger main camera has one of the new Sony Lightia sensors and does have optical image stabilization. The 3X telephoto camera that's resting on the vapor chamber has a new tetra prism design, which helps it take up less room inside of the phone. It also has OIS and EIS, and can apparently zoom in 120 times, which I should have tested before ripping it out of the phone. The 50 megapixel ultra wide does not have OIS, but that's pretty normal for a wide angle camera. The charging port comes out next. This guy has a plethora of Lego style ribbon cables attached to it. Once it's out, we can see the 100 watt USB-C charging port does have a red rubber ring to help with the IP68 and IP69 water resistance ratings. The upgraded IP69 is what helps the phone survive high temperature water jets. It also helps the water resistant rating just last longer, which is a bigger deal now that people are keeping their phones for multiple years. The upper stereo speaker slash earpiece also has balls inside, and it's nice to see that we'll have good audio from both ends of the phone. Now, here is where our predicament arises. Like, I would like to see what the dual cryovelocity vapor chambers look like, but like usual, the passive cooling system is sandwiched between the aluminum frame and the 6.8 inch OLED display. And usually, I would only remove a screen if it's already broken, since they usually break during the removal, which would hurt me in this particular case, since not only does the display have 4,500 nits of peak brightness, but also scored an A++ from DisplayMate, which, like, if OnePlus keeps making phones, DisplayMate is gonna need to change their scoring system, because you can only add so many pluses. But I hope OnePlus isn't seeing this. It looks like this screen just ain't gonna make it. We can make some lemonade out of lemons though, because at least now we get to see the ultrasonic fingerprint reader, which works alongside the AquaTouch screen technology to unlock the phone even when your fingers are wet. And as we clearly saw back when the phone was alive, the next generation AquaTouch 2.0 allows the display to even respond when your hands are oily. With the screen gone, we can reach the dual cryovelocity vapor chamber. OnePlus has figured out that if you put a vapor chamber on top of your vapor chamber, you get a heat remover for your heat remover, removing a whole lot more heat than just one vapor chamber by itself. Just like a double-decker bus can move twice as many people, this double-decker capillary action does the same thing with heat. Hot vapor flows to the edge of the chamber where it can cool down and get wicked back to the center to repeat the cooling process on multiple levels. I'd like to thank OnePlus for letting me borrow their phone for a second, and maybe next time we should just send it non-destructively through an X-ray machine. Oh wait, I already did. My X-ray scan collab with Dbrand shows us every real-life circuit, battery cell, and speaker, and even though OnePlus has indeed prioritized durability this time around, protection is always going to be a good idea. I'll leave a link down in the description for the new OnePlus 13, as well as my X-ray scan, so you can see the insides on the outside without ever taking it apart. Thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.